So basically, this is a 2007 American. We started out, we took everything off of it, saved what we could. We stripped the entire chassis, rewelded some new tabs on it. We made a complete new body for it. Aluminum body, it was multi-piece aluminum. As you can see, we're having a little fun. It's on the body table, and we're never serious, so it was a great time doing it. Trav definitely taught me a lot, and it's just cool to be a part of something like, you know, you can say that you got to help build your own car, which is pretty cool to say. For the chassis color, we decided we wanted to do a misty lava with a fog clear. So misty lava with a fog clear, basically it's like a dull or matte gray instead of that shiny gray.
Yeah, it looks like we've got the fucking back door. I've got the front door, so I told you to...
I didn't hear you.
Or you didn't want to?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, you did not want to.
As you can see here, Trav's applying that fog clear over top of that misty lava just to give it that dull look. But it's super important that you completely cover the entire chassis, you know, even in the welds and stuff. So we let him take care of that a little bit, and then we checked it out and threw it in the oven. And then when it came out, I was super excited with how it came out. We haven't done this chassis color a lot at all, so it was really cool to kind of see a different chassis color than, you know, what always goes out our door. There was a lot of hands that went into helping do this chassis. Bill, you know, he helped us mount the tires. He helped us wire the fuel tech. You know, fuel tech wasn't something that we did a lot of, but with the help of Bill and Andre at fuel tech, it went together fairly smooth. And you know, once we got it all together, it's pretty cool to see all the different sensors that fuel tech has. So I'm super excited with the fuel tech 550 dash and how it turned out. But by far the wiring process was a lot. Like I said, it took all hands on deck. It was all of us in there and late at night and on weekends, because, you know, it is our personal car. So during the weekdays and stuff, we have customers stuff to get done. So it was a lot of late nights and a lot of weekends that we spent on this car. And then Trav, Mom, and I dropped the motor in. You know, put oil in it, put water in it, and kind of just started zip tying everything together and putting everything on. But it was definitely a long but awesome process to be a part of. I got to thank Marco Abruzzi, Abruzzi Transmissions and Converters. Obviously, that's what we decided to go with in this car, and it has the same transmission and converter in it still to this day, that from the first one we put in, and it's worked great. And Marco's always been there, you know, if we did have problems or even just set up stuff, you know, getting the shifter linkage correct. Marco is always there, so huge shout out to him. He's always been there. He's a great guy to support us. Mosier Engineering, Rob Mosier, for rear end, center section, brakes, axles. I trust Rob to put that on my car any day. Not only is it safe, but I believe it's the best out there. So I have to give a shout out to Rob Mosier and the entire Mosier Engineering team, as you know, they sent us all of this stuff and we were able to put it together. And if we had any questions, Rob was a phone call away, whether it was 7 a.m. or 7 p.m. He was there to help us out. So that was pretty cool. Christopher Snyder at Stainless Works, he helped us out a ton with the headers. You know, we believe that great customer service kind of goes a long way, and it's what we do, and it's exactly what Christopher did as well. So that was pretty cool. Eric Davis at Penske Racing Shocks, we decided to put a Penske Racing Shock on it, and you can see it's got the fuel tech sensor as well. But, you know, setup-wise, Eric gave us his standard, what you should set it up as. And then Trav and I basically sat in it. We got it all set up. So that was pretty cool. We decided to put the Hoosier 1350s on it. And every track I've been to, I've been able to get down the track perfectly fine. So they've worked great. We got our float kit on it so I don't overfill the tank. When that light comes on, basically I know to stop filling up the car. Thanks to Peter, Sal, and Rich at Beyond Air Racing Products, we got the Elite Outlaw shifter in the car. I gotta say, one of my favorite parts is Trav and I decided to weld some extra light tabs in there, so that was pretty cool. We got purple lights in there. Trevor Wiggins at Get 'Em Performance, he helped us from day one put this Get 'Em carburetor on it. And I'm telling you guys, this thing is consistent as all get out. I don't think, like, the first weekend I went out, I don't think it varied, like, two thou. So that was pretty cool. But I appreciate everyone's support. It couldn't have been done without them. A huge thank you to my mom and Trav for making it possible. And hopefully we can park it in the winter circle soon. But thank you to everyone's support. And let's go racing.
Okay, let's go.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, or whatever, if you want.